Okay, we are back. Thank you.
Terrific.
Thank you.
And you got nice rosy cheeks now. Oh, is that great?
Rosy cheeks. Well, there goes dinner at the White House. Well,
that was
anyway.
Oh.
I want to thank Fred Holliday, the actor, for playing Jim Baker. He did a wonderful job.
Yeah.
And did you know?
You were too busy following himself on the commercial.
Fred told me. He says, my commercial just followed.
Right.
It was a commercial he was doing. Anyway, my next guest, you all know well. They are two most talented gentlemen who left the grapes temporarily to be here tonight. They'll be appearing at the Front Row Theater in Cleveland, Ohio, from May 25th through the 30th. Would you welcome Tom and Dick, the Smothers Brothers.
I just want to say something to clear the air a little bit before we start. This is a good opportunity to do this. I'm sorry to stop you guys and everything. But my brother and I just remembered this, Tommy. My brother and I have been accused quite often, I might say, and I don't know why, but we've been accused of never finishing a song once we start it.
Yeah.
And
we're going to...
Just a second. You stop for just a second. And I want to say right now that my brother and I always finish every song. Throughout the years, we've been in business over 20 years, we've finished every song we've ever started. I don't know how that got around, but we do finish every song. Isn't that right, Tom?
That's right. I don't know how that got around.
We finish every song.
That's right. I don't know how that got around that we never finished a song. I have no idea how that got around.
I don't know how it got around, and we finish every song. I just wanted to make that statement right now. We finish every song. Sometimes in the dressing room, but we do finish the song eventually. I just wanted to make that clear. Thank you. Okay. No, but the point, now I remember, the point of me bringing this up is, the fact is that we are going to finish this particular song. We're going to sing this song from beginning, isn't that right?
That's right.
Start to finish this particular song. And by the way, I should maybe introduce the song. The song is not a run-of-the-mill pop song, you know, trendy pop song, because that's not where we're from. My brother and I are historical singers. Now, but this isn't a historical song, but it is in the other sense, because this is a song of the 80s. And we think this song we're going to sing in just a minute is going to be a folk song of the 80s. They have to come from somewhere. And this is a real song. It's a love song. And Tommy and I found this song in San Francisco just recently. Isn't that right, Tom?
That's right.
We found this song in San Francisco. It's a love song. And it's about how difficult interpersonal relationships are becoming. We have a complicated world, and our relationships are becoming very, very complicated. This song could be about your love life, or your friend's love life, or about nobody in particular. But anyway, that's what this song is about, and I wanted to mention that. And oh, by the way, just remember that this song, isn't this right, Tom? This song is going to be sung from beginning to end without stop. And the lyrics, you have to listen very carefully to the lyrics, because the lyrics are quite complicated, just like interpersonal relationships are becoming. Right?
Right.
Okay, so listen to the lyrics quite carefully. It's entitled, Four Hearts in a Snaggle.
First I met you, then I liked you, then I loved you. And you loved me till you met him, then you left me. And I missed you till I met her and forgot you. Till she left me when she met him and he left you. Then I called you and I saw you and forgave you. And you loved me and I loved you till I saw her. He had left her, hurt her, and she missed me. So I left you like you left me when you met him. Then you found him and you loved him and forgot me. Oh boy. But then she left me when she called him and he left you. When you saw me, I love you, but she's left him, so I'm leaving. Yes, I love you, but she's left him, so I'm leaving with him.
Well, that...
Beginning to end.
That is a song of today, isn't it?
Yes, it's a message song
that one should...
It's a song that probably a lot of people have lived in, and will live.
Or will live, or should have lived. Or might like to have lived. How are you?
We're very good.
Fine, that was a wonderful sketch.
Thank you.
So classic, and you look more like Ronald Reagan than Rich Little did. That was a great
makeup. Well, thank you. That's very nice.
The thing is, I think you're a little quick for Ronald.
A little quick?
Yeah. Ooh. I mean, he understood too much.
Too much, huh?
Too much. Did I say that?
There goes dinner at the White House for you, too.
Oh, yeah.
Somebody tells me, thank you, you sent me some bottles of your wine from your vineyard under your own label.
Mm-hmm.
You've been bottling all day, is that the correct word, bottling?
Yeah. Actually, I bottled all day yesterday, and we have about 10 more days. It's sort of a strange setup. We don't have a lot of money, so we have more labor intensive.
Yeah.
And in the bottling sequence, you start with a dumper and in a blower,
yeah.
And he does both jobs. He dumps the bottles and blows them out to get the dust out.
I know nothing about this.
This is the thing that may
say a trip out here through the Sonoma or Napa Valley is a thing to do in California.
Oh, it's wonderful. It's very romantic.
Beautiful country. And
the thing is, I think a bottling wine or making wine is almost like going through rehearsal in a Broadway show or seeing a movie made. If you see all the elements in the rehearsal and it's not quite like it seems when you're sitting at a nice table with.
Yeah.
Soft lights.
Now, you mentioned dumping, and what is the term nerping?
Well, I'm the best nerper in the line, actually.
Oh, I don't know what the nerper
is. Well,
the
nerper is, do you ever, when you get a bottle of wine, it has a lead top, right? That's called foil.
Yeah.
And you take the foiler does that. But see, after the dumper and the blower, you have to have a filler and a corker.
Right,
and then,
I understand
then
corker.
Then they pass it to the wiper.
Yeah, I need
because
wipe.
You spill when you fill.
What's the nerper?
Well, I haven't got there yet.
You haven't got there to
no,
the
this,
yet.
No, this is the sequence.
I see.
After the wiper, it goes to the foiler. Now,
all
the foiler
right.
takes these little lead things that's on the top of the bottles of wine, and you just lightly set them. And they're much larger in diameter than the neck of the bottle. In comes the nerper. It's this fantastic little machine. You take your bottle with your oversized lead foil,
right.
and you stick it in the nerper.
And that?
Yes, but you just can't stick it in like this. It has to have rhythm.
Well,
I primarily get to do the nerping.
Because you have that sense of...
I have that sense of...
Nerping.
Putting it in.
Yeah.
It's just not putting it in. If you get a guy on the nerping machine that has a little bit off to one side, you get a wrinkle in your nerping.
Well, no, nobody wants that.
And I'm on the labeler, and the labeler is very critical because you straighten out the label. Then we go to the presser, then the stuffer, and then the packer and the stacker.
It's a very involved process, isn't it?
The packer. It's sort of like you're making your suits.
I know one thing about wine.
What?
I wonder if you know. Do you know what they call that indentation at the bottle, in a bottle of wine, that curvature? What that is called? There's a name for that.
No, I don't know. That.
You know that indentation in the bottle of a, in the
yes,
bottom
like
of a bottle of wine.
Yes, like in champagne,
you know what that's called?
What?
It's called a kick.
A kick?
Mm-hmm.
Why does? Because it feels
good. I don't
good?
Know. That's called a kick, and I don't.
Oh, I knew that.
Well, if time ran out. You would have won the oven, but you heard the buzzer. Did you hear the buzzer, folks? You didn't get in before the buzzer.
I don't work real fast.
Yeah.
Anyway, I've talked off and on about the wine on your show, and finally, I brought some in my suitcase for you to try.
I saw it up in the office, and it's very nice of you.
Don't drink it in Beverly Hills, but drink it anywhere you want.
Oh, sure. Okay. I'll try it out. Yes.
It's really good stuff.
Are you? You say you're not making a lot of money from this?
I'm working hard on it. In fact, as we're going on the road, as you mentioned, we're going to be with Ben Vereen.
And
Cleveland. What a talented guy.
And a lot of things have been happening, John.
Why don't you fill us in, Tom, and just give us some of the things that...
Well, so we're doing a lot of things on the road. We're doing a lot of clubs and stuff, but primarily television is coming back for Dick and I now. Things are looking good. We've got a major two-part dramatic series start the opening of next season because most of the shows are running down now. It's getting to summertime.
Right.
And we've got a two-parter with probably one of the best shows on television.
A hot show.
And it's a show that...
It's the debut show.
It's a two-hour extended thing featuring Dickie and I on the Lou Grant show.
Really, that's true.
Your agent worked that out for next season.
He doesn't know it's not really here.
Tommy doesn't know.
Well, it's the whole thing. The script is great because... What?
I didn't have the heart to tell him.
Tell me what?
The Lou Grant show. was canceled for fall.
It was. I forgot to tell you.
Oh, no. What?
It's canceled. It's not going on in the fall.
You know, the funny thing is that the script we're doing...
It's perfect for you.
...was perfect for... Both Dickie and I are in the script, and it was an investigative reporting thing about how this our show, The Smothers Brothers, how we were thrown off for political reasons.
Right.
It was a whole two-hour thing, how we were thrown off.
And you were going to open the fall season on the...
Yeah, well, that's...
But that wasn't the whole thing. The premise of the show is how much things have loosened up since those days.
Yeah, and how things have loosened up in total. Yeah.
That's right, well...
And we helped do it.
Maybe next season after that.
Yeah, maybe another joke, too.
Yes, I think... yes, Leonard Nimoy goes in search of a finish. We'll be back. We'll be back in just a moment. There'll be a whole new show next year. Okay, we're back. Joe Bob, is that... How much time do we have here, Mr. D?
4 minutes, I think.
Mr. D is lacing a cup of coffee with something over there.
What? The clock.
That's the actual...
If we sing right now, we'll be all right.
Would you guys like to sing again?
Yeah,
we could do something. Yeah.
Sure.
Oh, they're not so sure.
This is an old song we've done a lot of times, but it's a song that is kind of appropriate because... Sunday is a day for us that is
it's our holiday.
It's our holiday. It's been even before famous people celebrating our
every
our,
year.
Yes, I didn't know.
Didn't you know it's a national holiday?
Smothers Day.
Smothers Day. Yes. Smothers Day. You're right.
And so we're going to sing a song about our father.
Oh, my old man's a sailor. What do you think about that? He wears a sailor's collar, he wears a sailor's hat. He wears a sailor's raincoat, he wears a sailor's shoes. And every Saturday evening, he reads the Sunday news. And someday, if I can, I'm gonna be a sailor, the same as my old man.
My old man's an anthropologist, what do you think about that? He wears an anthropologist collar, wears an anthropologist hat. He wears an anthropologist raincoat, he wears anthropologist shoes. And every Saturday evening he reads the anthropologist news. And someday,
hey, if I can,
I'm gonna be an anthropologist, the same as my old man.
Oh, my old man's refrigerator repairman, what do you think about that? He wears a refrigerant pearman's collar, wears a refrigerant hat, wears a refrigerant pearman's raincoat, he wears a refrigerant shoes. Every Saturday morning, he reads the refrigerant news.
And someday, if I can,
I'm gonna be a refrigerant pearman, same as my old man.
My old man's a cotton-picking, finger-licking chicken plucker. What do you think about that?
I think you better not make a mistake.
He wears a cotton-picking, finger-licking, chicken-plucker's collar. He wears a cotton-picking, finger-licking, chicken-plucker's hat. He wears a cotton-picking, finger-licking, chicken-plucker's raincoat. He wears cotton-picking, finger-licking, chicken-plucker's shoes.
What about
and
socks?
And someday...
What? I said, what about socks?
He wears cotton-picking, finger-licking, chicken-plucker socks.
What about spats?
He wears cotton-picking, finger-licking, chicken-plucker spats.
What kind of... What?
Cotton-picking, finger-licking, chicken-plucker spats.
What about a beret?
Was cotton picking fingerling and chicken flickers beret.
What about and strawberries?
It was cotton picking fingerling and chicken flickers strawberries.
What about a bra?
Was cotton picking fingerling and chicken flickers bra. And
he's
some,
he's your old man's a friend.
And someday, I'm gonna be a cotton picking fingerling and chicken plucker.
The same as mine.
Refrigerator repairman. You work so well together.
Yeah, well, that's our business.
Yeah. You got it. I never looked at it that way. You go right to the heart of the matter. Tom, we'll take a break. We'll be right back. Stay where you are.